encourage innovators, creators, and inventors.
Wow, very
good. So this
good.
Is the under the sponsorship of the International IP Institute. It's an American-based non-governmental organization in partnership with IP Philippines. Mm-hmm. And tomorrow will also be an event for signing memorandum of agreements for academic institutions and the Department of Science and Technology to establish what we call the Innovation and Technology Support Offices.
Mm-hmm. And you've been heading this Innovation and Technology Support Offices that have started opening all over the country.
Yes, when we started it, we were just hoping that about 10 academic institutions will join the project. But right now, we're more than 20.
Wow,
and there are
very
at
fast.
Least six more.
Six more.
Well, signing the memorandum of agreement tomorrow. Mm-hmm. So that would include Ateneo, Adamson, and some state universities from north to south.
Mm-hmm. When we say innovation and technology support offices, they are located inside universities. Are they satellite offices of the IPO, or how
no,
does it work?
No, it's not a satellite office in the sense that the host institution will have to operate it and manage it and own it. It's like IPO is helping to build the capacity for these ITSOs to provide patent search information services, patent drafting, and IP management. So this would basically involve managing the researches of academic institutions and research and development institutes. Why? What's the importance? We've been doing a lot of research, and based on IP statistics at the IP Philippines office, very little are really protected. So we're not saying that there are no innovations and inventions
in
the countryside. But what's happening is Filipinos are not aware of how to protect. And sometimes we get to know of what I call, personally call, horror stories. Like, for example, there's a research done in an academic institution. It's published in a scientific or technical journal abroad. And by publishing, you lose the right to protect it through the patent system unless you file it within a year from your publication. It becomes public domain. So what's the implication? You poured in your time, effort, money to do the research.
Yes.
And at the end of the day,
You're not protected.
Oh. You cannot even use it sometimes. Yes. Or you find yourself with so many competitors around over the technology. So, you know.
So those are the horror stories that face our people who do not know that they have to protect their research and also their innovation.
Yes.
Okay.
And we don't want that to happen again.
Wow.
To our R&D institutes and academic institutions.
You are doing a very good and very heroic thing, if I must say, in protecting our youths and also our researchers. Now, you said there is no lack of innovation in the country.
Of course.
There is no lack of innovation. We only need to know how to protect them.
Yes. And you have to appreciate what you've done, because if you don't appreciate it, then you let others use it at the point of you yourself is precluded from using it because you did not protect it and somebody else got a patent for it.
Yeah.
You know, when they read in the journals that there is this technology and they search that there is no protection through the patent system, they can easily file a patent within the regulatory period.
Which is one year from
date of publication. So, it's sad.
It's sad, and at the same time, you're doing something about it.
Yes.
Di po ba?
And another objective is, we would like to encourage the utilization or commercialization of the products of these researchers. We don't want them to be staying in library, beautifully bound in a thesis or whatever, in a publication. We want our people to benefit from the technologies that are the product of these research.
Yes.
So it's a win-win situation. You get protection and you can now go out, go global if
go
you
global.
Want.
Yes,
and license your technology because you feel confident that you already have that protection.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, as I think in your other episodes of this program, it's territorial, right? So if you want to go global, you have to protect globally.
Yes, all right. So before I let Miss Carmen Peralta go, any exit messages to our televiewers out there?
You know, intellectual property is part of the nation's patrimony or wealth.
Very good. Yeah.
We need to encourage our scientists, our inventors, our innovators to produce more.
Mm-hmm.
Based on the experiences of countries, economic development simultaneously happened with the increase in innovation, invention, and creation of the people. But how can you encourage them? One is you have to respect the intellectual property of creative people.
That's right.
Respect means that you won't copy it without
permission.
You won't sell it without permission. And respect means that giving recognition to the scientists as an incentive for them to produce more innovative, inventive products.
Right.
So,
very well said.
Okay, so it's a whole cycle that, or it's a change of culture and mindset. We need to value our creations as Filipinos.
As Filipinos. There you have it. We need to value ourselves and our creations. Ms. Carmen G. Peralta of the Philippine Intellectual Property Office.
With more than 100 years of experience, the Madrid system has facilitated businesses in establishing more than 1 million marks worldwide. Trademark owners enjoy a flexible and cost-effective single procedure to protect simultaneously their mark in more than 80 countries, or by selecting a few, according to their business needs. Trademark owners simply need to fill in, from their national office, one form, in one language, pay one set of fees in one currency, to obtain and modify an international registration. Trademark owners benefit from online tools to search existing marks, browse the WIPO Gazette, estimate filing costs, make e-payments and renewals, and check registration status. This unique service offered by the Madrid system eases the registration and management of a mark or a large portfolio. It empowers businesses and helps expand their market abroad. The number one solution for international trademark registration, the Madrid system, is brought to you by the World Intellectual Property Organization. With more than 100 years of experience, the Madrid system has facilitated businesses in establishing more than 1 million marks worldwide. Trademark owners enjoy a flexible and cost-effective single procedure to protect simultaneously their mark in more than 80 countries, or by selecting a few, according to their business needs. Trademark owners simply need to fill in, from their national office, one form, in one language, pay one set of fees in one currency to obtain and modify an international registration. Trademark owners benefit from online tools to search existing marks, browse the WIPO Gazette, estimate filing costs, make e-payments and renewals, and check registration status. Mm. This unique service offered by the Madrid system eases the registration and management of a mark or a large portfolio. It empowers businesses and helps expand their market abroad. The number one solution for international trademark registration, the Madrid system, is brought to you by the World Intellectual Property Organization.
In my life, I have introduced a lot of very important people. But tonight, I am humbled to introduce to you, someone of you all the way from Geneva, to help us, the Philippine government, in general, and the IPO field in particular, promote our early accession to the Madrid system. She will introduce not only the Madrid system, but she will also introduce to you WIPO, the World Intellectual Property Organization. I am humbled to introduce to you WIPO Deputy Director General Wang. Madam Wang, please.
Dear Director General Blanco, distinguished guests, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Actually, what was said by the Director General made me even more humble. I'm here on behalf of WIPO, on behalf of the Director General of the World Intellectual Property Organization, Dr. Gary, to lead the team to be to help and provide with the effort that I did in composed of about 85 member states. This infirmary is aimed to provide service to trademark owners, trademark users, trademark practitioners, and trademark attorneys. And above all, this system provides service for the benefit of the economic development of our member states. WIPO, as one of the 16 specialized agencies of the UN family, we are the leading organization in the field of intellectual property. I think everybody knows that at this time of the point, in particular, after the, well, we are still in the process of recovering from last financial crisis. But nevertheless, this recovery has brought up lots of chances as well as challenges and maybe sometimes risks. But however, the system we are introducing here is going to bring in some more energy to push the recovery faster and smoother. Why? One of the reasons is that because we are dealing with trade, and the trademark is a mark or could be a brand which will help the trade growth. And also trademark is very close to our daily life because everything we have or everything we touch or everything we may want to even buy to eat may have a trademark. So you see how close it is to our routine life. So this is why we are very proud of being here. And also we are very proud of the excellent achievement made by IPO Philippines. Over the last, one and a half days, we have wandered through three intensive seminars dealing with various kinds of issues considering this important treaty we are administrating. We have been in intensive discussion with trademark owners, practitioners, trademark attorneys. I think we have been very convincing together with our colleagues in the